Peter Solari, and the beautiful lady with me is Anna Alicia, better known to most of you as Melissa Agretti Cumson Gioberti of Falcon Crest.
And you know Peter as Michael Harris at the Newhart Show.
We're staked out here at the anchor position for the fabulous 29th annual Cotton Bowl Parade.
Today, Peter and I will be teaming up with two other members of the CBS family to bring you the play-by-play description here on Commerce Street in Dallas. Let's check in with our two colleagues up at the starting line. They're Martha Smith of The Scarecrow and Mrs. King and Ken Kershaw of Dallas. Martha, Ken, are you two all ready for the action?
I'm ready. How about you, Martha?
I'm all ready. I hope you folks at home are ready, too, because we've got a really great show coming up. This is a very special edition of the Cotton Bowl Parade this year because we're celebrating the Texas Sesquicentennial.
And on this 150th anniversary, we'll be seeing and hearing all kinds of tributes to the Lone Star State, as well as leaping through some fascinating pages of Texas history. So let's get things off to a flying start. Back to you, Peter.
Thank you, Ken. Stand by, everyone, because here it comes, the 1986 Cotton Bowl Parade. Are you ready, Honor Lee?
Oh, you bet, Peter! Here they are, all 65 of them, the Kilgore College Rangerettes of Kilgore, Texas. They're billed as the world's first dancing girl team, and they've been lighting up the Texas sky since the group was formed back in 1940.
I used to kick like that.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. The Rangerettes are goodwill ambassadors for the state of Texas, and for the whole United States, for that matter. They have, in their time, performed in Venezuela, Hong Kong, Korea, and Romania, which I have not done. And next month, they'll be appearing at the 102nd Annual Carnival in Nice, France.
In those costumes, they'll be a lot warmer down there on the French Riviera.
Oh, my God. Did you see that move?
Oh, my Lord. Look at that.
Their director, Dina Bolton, rehearses their routines every day, 10.5 hours a week, and it shows. Sometimes they rehearse even more, like when a special event is coming up, our Cotton Bowl Parade, for instance.
Let's hear it. Look at them. Look at that. Aren't they wonderful?
We're just pausing in our coffee here to kind of marvel at these gals. Let's hear it for the Kilgore Rangerettes. Boy, they are something else. In fact, we saw them when we first came out at 6:30, and they are going crazy over this gal.
You know what's amazing is how beautiful the weather is today. It's a little bit chilly, but it's just beautiful here today.
Yeah, it's a great improvement on what I think they were referring to earlier, the ice bowl of a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
Here they go again.
Boy, they have to be so flexible. They really do have to work out every day to be able to do that.
Certainly before noon.
Yeah.
I never try anything like that until at least 4:30 in the afternoon.
Whoa! Oh, they're just wonderful. Ah, yes.
Showstoppers. And the show just started.
They've got rhythm, too. Oh, let's just hear it for the Kilgore Rangerettes, the original Lone Star Chorus line. Those girls' faces.
Yeah, they know they did well.
Yes, they do. Oh, they're just so precious.
What we're seeing now is the musical backup for the Rangerettes, and they are the Kilgore College Ranger Band. These fine musicians have been adding color to the Cotton Bowl festivities since 1949.
Wow.
Let's listen while we look.
The band is going to make a trip to Nice next month along with the Rangerettes. South of France in February. It makes me wish I hadn't given up the tuba, Peter.
Well, there's still time.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you. learn, I swear. Here, coming into your viewing screen, are an elite group of horsemen. They are the Dallas Police Department Mounted Unit.
And now, the visiting dignitary, His Excellency Governor Mark White and his wife, Mrs. Linda Gale White.
They're certainly riding in style in a beautifully restored Brougham evening coach. It was built in 1883. It's currently on display at the Pate Museum of Transportation in Preston, Texas. It's just outside Fort Worth. The rear guard escort for Governor White. This is another official equestrian outfit. It is the Dallas Park Police Mounted Unit.
The duties of this group include patrolling the city's parks, crowd control, and participation in civic events like this one, Peter.
They're a very smart-looking outfit, I must say. Obviously, Governor and Mrs. White are in very good hands.
Don't they look handsome?
And the governor is stopped for a moment by a traffic problem. Maybe he can call somebody higher up and help him get out of there.
Oh, we really appreciate him coming here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we really do.
And now they seem to be getting to move.
Yes, goodbye,
here.
Excellency.
Is he waving at us?
If you had any doubt about the theme of this year's parade, this ought to clear it up. This book, sponsored by Jockeys, portrays the history of Six Flags over Texas.
That giant map you're seeing now is adorned by the six flags that have flown over Texas through its turbulent history. You folks at home, see if you can identify them in the next few seconds.
Besides the flags, the float pays tribute to the industries of Texas. Cotton, fruits and vegetables, and her mineral wealth, cattle, and of course, oil. All right, Peter, now give us the answer to your history quiz, right?
Okay, the answers to the pop quiz are... The Six Flags over Texas have been Spain, France, Mexico, her own Lone Star flag for 10 years when she was the Republic of Texas, then the Stars and Bars of the Confederacy, and finally, the Stars and Stripes of the United States of America. Since Alaska was admitted to the Union, Texas is now only the second largest state. The Texans say, yeah, wait till Alaska thaws out.
Yeah, wait till Alaska thaws out.
Indeed. It would take some time for this float to thaw out. It is huge.
You know, people think that Texas is such a small state, and they'll think, well, you're just going to Dallas from El Paso, what, a couple hours? Well, here's a very special character in this year's Cotton Bowl Parade. He's the official mascot of the 1986 Texas Sesquicentennial RT Texadillo. Wonderful parade, Peter.
It certainly is. The greatest. Beautiful girls, spirited horses, colorful floats. It's marvelous. The only trouble is, it's so hard to learn to pronounce Sesquicentennial.
I know. But we're learning, and very shortly we'll be reminded of our Six Flag theme again, this time on horseback.
Stay with us.
Of the Six Flag theme coming up. Watch this.
Here's an impressive double sextet. Six horses, six riders, and Six Flags Texas. The cowgirls are all students at Harson Simmons University in Abilene, Texas, and their mounts are matched quarter horses. Ah, they have beautiful horses. Beautiful girl.
They certainly are, and these young ladies get around. They have appeared at five presidential inaugural parades and hundreds of rodeos and parades throughout the country, including the Thanksgiving Day parade in New York. Oh, wouldn't it be fun to do that, Ken?
Yeah, it would, but I'd never pass the physical.
Yeah. Well, right behind the six lovely flag bearers, here are the high-stepping members of the same school, the Harden Simmons University Cowboy Band.
There they are, marching along with their Eyes of the Country on them and playing what else? The Eyes of Texas Are Upon You.
Oh, look at that. They really embody the spirit of Texas, don't they, with the old west and the cowboy outfits, all that energy. Let's listen.
Thank you. you sports fans. Here are the newly inducted members of the Texas Hall of Fame.
That's George Foreman of Houston, Olympic gold medalist and former professional heavyweight boxing champion of the world.
Blocking back Forrest Gregg of Southern Methodist University, Super Bowl starter with the Green Bay Packers, later Super Bowl coach with Cincinnati.
Elvin Hayes, All-American basketball star at the University of Houston, 16 years a professional with the Washington Bullets and the Denver Rockets.
Ernie Coy, senior of the University of Texas, outfielder with the Brooklyn Dodgers and the St. Louis Cardinals.
Otis Mitchell, 42 winning seasons, head football coach at four Texas high schools and North Texas State University.
Bill Scovell, Wichita Falls, former director of the Dallas Cowboys, 30 years as chairman of the Cotton Bowl Team Selection Committee.
And missing from our lineup of honorees is international motorsports champion Carol Shelby, who unfortunately couldn't be with us today.
And posthumously, the late J. Curtis Sanford, founder of the annual Cotton Bowl Classic in 37.
All champions, all Texans.
And here, direct from Disneyland in sunny California, a team of beautiful perch on horses pulling a genuine 1907 calliope. Now, that's the way the old-timers pronounced it, calliope, and there's our old friend Mickey Mouse.
Mickey Mouse! Hi, Mickey! Oh, well, here's an echo of the Old West, representing the Texas Wagon Train Association. During the coming year, this colorful caravan plans to circle the state with 150 wagons in a salute to the first 150 years of Texas history.
The two units are driven respectively by the association's director, Jan France of Sulphur Springs, and by 78-year-old Hazel Brown, also of Sulphur Springs. Local radio station WBPAE will be sending us lots of lucky listeners to join the wagon train for 2 days. The state of Texas is having itself quite a celebration on its 150th anniversary.
It certainly is. You know, I would almost be willing to celebrate my own 150th birthday if they give me a party like this one, Ken.
There's a lot more coming up. Our partners, Peter Scolari and Annalisa, will be back shortly with more excitement right after this.
From all of us here at Airwolf,
to all of you out there,
season's greetings.
I think there are three nevers to being a winning coach. Never let the press pick your starting quarterback. Never take a last place team lightly. And really, no matter what the score, never let them see you sweat.
That's what new Dry Idea aerosol.
Larry here, back with Anna Alicia and our camera crew with more of the 1986 Cotton Bowl Parade.
And to lead off this part of the festival, we've got one of the most exciting vocal groups you'll ever hear.
They are the International Championship Men's Barbershop Chorus, known as the Vocal Majority. They're based right here in Dallas, Texas.
They're going to perform a special sesquicentennial, I can't even say it, I can't still get it, anthem to Texas, written especially for the occasion by Alexander Harvey, composer of many of Kenny Rogers' hit songs.
And here they are, under the direction of Smiling Jim Clancy, the 110 voices of the Vocal Majority singing No Place But Texas.
Yeah.
wonder they've won the world championship four times in 10 years.
Here's something else that happens no place but Texas. It's the royal court of the Cotton Bowl Princesses, sponsored by the Cotton Bowl Council.
These lovely young ladies represent the schools of the Southwest College Conference, one of which sends its football team to the annual Cotton Bowl football game.
Hey, let's introduce these regal ladies. From the University of Arkansas, Betty Sturgis.
From Baylor, Donna Reed.
Loved her show. From the University of Houston, Kim Havert.
From Southern Methodist, Elizabeth Papel.
Glad you had to say that one. From Texas A&M, Donna Banfield.
From Texas Christian, Jill Davis.
And from Texas Tech, Holly Griffin.
And from the University of Texas, Teresa Alexander.
From Rice, Patty Neum.
And from Auburn University, Pam Scott.
Boy, here's to the radiant royalty of the Southwest College Conference. They're a credit to the Texas Sesquicentennial. Hey, I said it pretty well, that's...
You sure did. I'm so embarrassed.
Practice, that's all.
All right, I'll try. Top-notch troupe of music makers from Robinson High School in Waco, Texas, or as you said, Waco, Texas, yesterday, but I say Waco, Texas, known as the Pride of the Blue. The song they're playing, like the hometown they represent, is deep in the heart of Texas.
Doesn't that make your spurs go jingle, jangle, jingle? Oh. Let's listen. We're glad they did. We've got to tell you, folks, we're sitting here along the curve, and this is an exciting parade for everyone.
Oh, absolutely. I'm so proud to be a Texan, Peter. I can't tell you.
All right, I admit I'm a little jealous.
I know all my family's out there right now watching, and they're all Texans. My Uncle Louie, my brothers, my mom, everybody, my grandma, my sister.
Our best to them.
Yeah. Oh, this beautiful white vis-a-vis carriage dates back to the early 19th century. Look at that.
It's lovely. The driver that we're now seeing is Charles T. Smith. Behind him are his passengers. They are his family, in fact. Dressed in costumes of the 1830s are his wife, Iris, his 11-year-old son, Charlie, and his 6-year-old daughter, Carrie. Well, Ana Alicia, all this must make you proud of your home state. You grew up in Texas, as we just discussed, did you not?
That's right, El Paso to be exact. Halfway across the country from your home turf, it was Westchester County, New York, wasn't it?
Yes, not too many cowboys and Yonkers. But somehow, we both wound up in Dallas on New Year's Day, 1986.
And having a wonderful time at the 29th Annual Cotton Bowl Festival, with more to come in a few moments. There are a lot of happy faces along the line of march today, so let's just keep them smiling, shall we? What's up next, Ken?
Well, here's an eye-catcher. The Rough Riding Wranglers from Booker's Dude Ranch, riding three beautiful Palominos. They rode with us in the Cotton Bowl 2 years ago. They're backed by popular demand.
Look at that. Each horse is decked out in a silver-trimmed saddle, and each rider is costumed in gold and white, topped with a white cowboy hat. Riders at Booker T. Washington, Ernest Tanner, and Calvin Pregan. Now this float, sponsored by Budweiser, should warm the cockles of every American patriot heart in our audience. It portrays America the Beautiful.
The horsepower is provided by those world-famous Clydale horses, and they're driven by Uncle Sam himself. America, as the land of plenty, is symbolized by the king-sized cornucopia spilling out nature's bounty of fruit and vegetables.
In the float's midsection there, there's an old-fashioned gazebo with a picnic cart band playing nostalgic tunes from the past.
Its passengers include couples wearing costumes from different eras in American history, from American Indians to contemporary sweethearts. A huge American flag drapes the entire float, and the whole tableau is topped by the weather vane of the Liberty Hall.
Looks like some pilgrim settlers there. Okay, all you band buffs are going to enjoy this group, the York Suburban Marching Knights of York, Pennsylvania.
Since the band was formed 28 years ago, the Marching Knights have displayed their talents at festivals and parades, bowl games, all around the country. Canada, too. And their list of credits also includes two World Series games. Let's listen to this.
Okay.
Here in the city of Dallas back in 1884. It was restored by the members of the Dallas Fire Department. Now it's on permanent exhibition at the Dallas Firefighters Museum. They got its name, Old Tige, from one of the city's most respected mayors, W.L. Cabell, whose nickname was Old Tige because of his daring exploits as a Confederate general.
You know what time it is?
Sure I do. This is the central time zone, so in Dallas it is now.
No, I don't mean that. I mean what it's time for us to do. It's time for all of our CBS stations to identify themselves.
Oh, yeah, of course. And we'll be right back with more of this great parade with commentary continued by Annalisa and Peter Scalati.
Back with Annalisa and more of the fabulous Cotton Bowl Parade from deep in the heart of downtown Dallas.
And as always, Dallas is doing its usual number with that special hospitality it's famous for.
It's a great city, wonderful people, and as we promised, a really fantastic parade.
Yeah.
Now, this snappy assemblage of young musicians hails from, which is a slightly different word, hails from Denison.
Very different.
Yeah, thank you, dear. they come from Denison, Texas, the birthplace of former President Dwight D. Eisenhower. I didn't know that.
Well, I didn't know that. For the information of non-Texans, Denison is in the northeast part of the state, in the Red River Valley, up on the Oklahoma border. The members of this band are proud of their scholarship as well as their musicianship. 45 of them are on the school's honor roll. That's wonderful, isn't it?
Yeah. Sure is.
It's a really tough schedule to be able to keep up the grades and the music. It's just exceptional.
I'll tell you, I bet one thing helps the other.
Oh, that's very true.
Because there's a lot of enjoyment in that kind of music.
A lot of discipline, too,
yeah.
I'm sure.
Yeah, carries over. Why didn't we do it? Get that tuba back.
Well, that's right. I gave up the tuba, but I did get it. You know, I was in the top 2% of my class here.
Well, I was too, but I bribed people to get there.
I knew.
No, I'm kidding. Please, don't send letters in. People who I bribe.
Look at those. Look at those. Oh, they're wonderful. Look at how serious he is.
Well, I guess if you had to play and march at the same time, you'd be pretty serious.
Oh, they work so hard.
Look at the age of some of these
children. I know.
It
makes me feel so old.
I had to be dressed at that age.
You still do, from what I hear.
Now from Southampton, New York, coming onto your viewing screen, from halfway across the country, in fact, comes the Southampton Volunteer Fire Department. We met these folks the other night. These are a bunch of nutty special guys. And they are the antique truck and muster unit. The marchers are wearing their Class A uniforms today. Scarlet blazers, and there's a salute. Gray flannel trousers and white gloves. Some regalia, isn't it?
Oh, they look handsome. How elegant. And right behind these dapper fire eaters, here comes, I don't know if you can see it on the screen, but here comes the antique truck and muster unit.
It's just sneaking in.
There they go. Okay, they call themselves the only operating antique fire department in America. They're led by the chief's car, a 1950 2015 Model T Ford. Oh, I'd love to have a car like that. It's driven by the unit's past captain and honorary chief, Paul Terry.
A special guest of honor is Mr. Peter Wolf, who, to his credit, never cried out as a boy. He's formerly of Southampton and now living right here in Dallas, Texas.
Following the chief's car is their pride and joy. There it is, a 1912 American LaFrance hook and ladder truck. Only three of these trucks were built in that year, and this is the only one that is still running.
I understand these guys do the maintenance on them themselves. And they
really?
With a lot of love, yeah, they're telling me to.
Boy, that's just a beautiful part of history right there.
Isn't it? Well, I was just going to say this is a 1937 GMC hose wagon. As long as we have a traffic delay, we're going to tell you more about it. It's driven by fireman Kenneth Bennett of the Southampton Hook and Ladder Company, number one. He holds the Medal of Valor for saving the life of a small child during a fire.
That's wonderful. We're so lucky we have people like that. Commerce Street now, the more visiting royalty. This float is the entry of the San Antonio Lutheran Charity Coronation Association. It's designed after the Japanese sunken gardens in San Antonio. Oh, San Antonio, such a beautiful place.
Yeah.
Complete with footbridge, pagoda, and one of the black cranes that weighed in the garden's lagoon. This one, the grand prize, Peter.
Well, to look at it, you can understand why. Princess Pier Matherson rides in front, and the mid-float area is presided over by three duchesses, Melissa Ann Lenz. We're seeing them now, Tracy Allen and Candace Stettler.
And riding high on the regal throne at the rear is Queen Christy Ann Hammonds. The girls made their beautiful costumes themselves with a little help from their friends and families. A happy combination of beauty and talent.
You're not kidding. Boy, that is so
fun. Look at that. Look at that train.
A branch of a law enforcement agency that dates back to 1904, the Mounted Horse Patrol Unit of the U.S. Border Patrol.
Oh, I always did love men in uniform. The original mounted inspectors, as they were called, and there were only 90 of them to patrol 8,000 miles of border, Peter, were required to furnish their own horses and sidearms.
But they established a reputation for expertise, for loyalty, and horsemanship that survives to the present day, and it makes the Border Patrol an admired and well-respected service.
So much fun. When I hear the bands and see the floats and the horses, oh, it's like being a kid again.
And there's a lot more yet to see in here, not only in the parade, but in the big Cotton Bowl football game this afternoon.
You bet.
On CBS. Incidentally, we're about to be serenaded by the marching band of the visiting school, Auburn University.
And we'll also meet the visiting queen ruling over her own personal float. All that will be described by Martha Smith and Ken Kershaw when we come back. So be back.
In this afternoon's Cotton Bowl game. Will you do the first introductions, Martha?
Yeah, I'd be glad to. All right. Well, listen to that. Now, even if you just tuned in, I'm sure you already know the visiting team for today's Cotton Bowl game is from Auburn University in Alabama. And here is their musical cheering section. More than 300 strong, the Auburn University marching band. Look at that eagle.
And they're whipping up the old school spirit with a rousing number called War Eagle.
Uh-huh.
Assisted by 11 baton twirlers, two drum majors, and a 25-membered flag corps. And 287 fine musicians. That's a lot of musicians. Let's listen. There's some tall girls there.
Yeah.
The Auburn University Band was formed in 1897. And that, they say, makes it one of the oldest band programs in the South. So this year, they're wearing snappy new West Point-style uniforms in the school colors of orange and blue. In the past 3 years, they've played for the greater glory of Auburn and the Tangerine, Sugar, and Orange Bowls.
We're proud to have them here at the Cotton Bowl this year.
Tribute to the visiting queen. She's the monarch of the invading forces who come to do battle with the native warriors in the annual Cotton Bowl Football Classic.
Riding on a float sponsored by the Cotton Bowl Council, this is Miss Pam Scott of Auburn University. Her carriage, decked with royal flags, rolls along with the traditional red carpet drawn by dashing white horses.
Yeah, she certainly does look regal. Any loyal subject would try to win that queen for a day. But I'm sure she'll be wearing a slightly different costume when her team goes out to do battle on the football field.
Yeah, of course she will. Can't I mean, even a queen has to relax sometimes, you know? Maybe a sweater and slacks.
Why not? She'll look like a blue blood in anything. Besides, the queen, that queen, can do no wrong, right?
Well, now here is a trick that's a lot harder than it looks, Ken. This is square dancing on a moving platform. These dancers are members of the North Texas Square and Round Dancing Association. And the moving platform is the deck of the old stern wheeler, the Texas Queen.
The dancers are costumed in the style of the late 1800s with the ladies in hoop skirts. The 16 couples dancing on this float built it themselves, volunteering all their time and labor.
A lot of work. This dedicated group, they call themselves Nortex for short, is made up of some 7,000 dance enthusiasts who belong to 135 clubs in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Listen to that.
The association is celebrating its 25th anniversary this year, and we wish them another 25 plus.
Look at that. Now we're going to shift gears from square dancing to march tempo. Here is the Anniston High School Band of Anniston, Alabama. They're doing the musical honors for their colorful colleagues, the Annabelle Dance Team.
The band uniforms are unusual with bridgeman hats, ruffled shirt fronts, and once again, those swashbuckling capes.
Now, the Annabelles, of course, have several uniforms. That includes a warm weather outfit with fringes and sequins that leave their shoulders bare. But in this weather, they're going to be wearing red and white knit tops and skirts with white canvas shoes and white gloves. They perform to the music of 145 splendid musicians. So let's listen while we look.
You know, that's very considerate to have warm and cold weather uniforms, isn't it?
It is.
How many times the bands out there think they've got to be freezing or whatever?
Girls are comfortable today here. Oh, good percussion on this band, huh? Great. Marvelous.
Go
out, take
this
dance, you don't
mind, yeah, can't? Yeah, they're so serious. I mean, they're seriously at it. That's grand.
The precise art there, the drums.
Adventurous spirit of Texas is celebrated by this Mayflower-sponsored float. It pays tribute to the early settlers who migrated west to Texas in the early days.
And this pioneer family is loaded up to head for the new frontier. Look at them as Grandma waves from the door of the cabin. Where's Grandma? I don't see her.
Where is Grandma?
There! Grandma's waving from the door of the cabin, and the children's friends are waving goodbye from the little red schoolhouse.
Yeah.
Look at that. There comes Grandma now.
Yeah, my ancestors went west and covered wagons, but you know, if you'd see my ancestors, you'd know why they kept the wagons covered.
Whoa.
No offense. My family's a great family.
What a parade this is, Ken. It just keeps coming at you.
Yep, there's lots more coming up, too, including the host university's band and their gracious ruler, the Cotton Bowl Queen.
Peter Scolari and Anna Alicia will be back with all of that.
Cotton
Cotton Bowl Parade, celebrating the 150th anniversary of the state of Texas.
We've already met the visiting band and the queen from Auburn University. Now let's give equal time to the host university, Texas A&M.
Well, now let's check out the Texas Aggie Band from Texas A&M in College Station, Texas.
Every one of the 273 members of this band is enrolled in the Corps of Cadets at Texas A&M. And they say this makes them the largest military band in the world. It certainly looks big enough to be that, and they're playing their own marching song, the Aggie War Hymn. Let's listen, Peter. I understand they have a lot of tradition at this university. It's really beautiful.
And now, Her Most Royal Highness, the Cotton Bowl Queen. At Texas A&M, she was homecoming queen for 1986. Her name is Donna Banfield, and her float is sponsored by the Cotton Bowl Council.
At the front of the float, there's the Kodak Golden Anniversary Cotton Bowl Trophy, commemorating 50 years of the Cotton Bowl Classic. It's the symbol of all the ceremonies connected with the annual Cotton Bowl Classic.
Dressed in that gorgeous sweeping gown, I'll tell you, Donna really does look every inch a queen. If that's the way a queen looks, I wouldn't mind being king for a day.
Swinging down Commerce Street now, here comes the Arkadelphia High School Band from Arkadelphia, Arkansas. Do you know where Arkadelphia is, Peter?
I must say I don't.
Well, it's halfway between Little Rock and Texarkana. Do you know where they are?
Oh, certainly.
Okay, where?
They're on both sides of Arkadelphia.
Somehow I knew you'd say that, Peter. And to raise money for their trip to Dallas, these kids held a car wash-a-thon and washed 1,000 cars in one Saturday afternoon. Where was mine?
Yeah, really, that's some energy. They're great. Let's listen. Excitement of the parade and the activity of marching and performing is keeping them warm because
That's true.
Some of these outfits are not Arctic gear.
But they have known colder hot bowls.
So we've heard. Yeah. The ice bowl of a couple of years ago. Well, we're very fortunate today. And our producer supplied us with space heater.
That's right. Are you gonna be going to the game today?
I think we're thinking about it.
Oh, it's gonna be a terrific game. Well, here's a float built around the theme of the Yellow Rose of Texas, sponsored by the city of Lamarck, located about 30 miles south of Houston.
This beautiful float was designed by two native sons of Lamarck who are studying architecture at the University of Houston.
The float is adorned by more than 300 yellow roses, including the large inverted rose forming the canopy at the rear, yellow tree roses on the terrace garden, and more yellow roses on the taffeta dresses worn by the three beautiful passengers, and they are beautiful. Goes with my outfit.
Well, following the yellow Texas roses, here's an outfit named for another famous Texas flower. They're the Texas Bluebonnet Mounted Drill Team. They hail from Duncanville, which is a suburb of Dallas.
This all-woman precision drill team performed intricate maneuvers accompanied by music. They've appeared at rodeos all over Texas and Oklahoma.
The Texas Bluebonnets have been riding together, as we understand it, for 10 years, and they've won a whole trophy room full of awards in drill competitions.
Two of the original members are still riding with the team, Donna Stokes and James Kaiser. They're the ones carrying the banner for you.
I don't want to let 1986 get any older without a holiday greeting from my friends and fellow cast members on the Newhart Show. To all of you, cast and crew, great writing staff, you nuts, Happy New Year.
Good idea. My best wishes to the very talented cast and crew and writers and everyone at Falcon Crest. Feliz Navidad, amigos.
Hear, hear. And to all you viewers out there, let me say, stick around. There's more of the 1986 Cotton Bowl Parade to come.
Basically, I'm a Goodwill ambassador. ambassador for the cotton industry, and not only am I a spokeswoman here in the United States, but also I'll be traveling on an international tour. And what better place to kick off a promotion for cotton other than the 50th annual Cotton Bowl and the Cotton Bowl Parade?
Carrie, a lot of people don't know, and I found a little bit about it. Your family has a special connection to Cotton Bowl history. You want to tell us a little bit about it?
Yes, my Uncle Dick played for the 1954 Rice football team when they were in the Cotton Bowl against the University of Alabama. And Uncle Dick was running down the sideline, making a 95-yard touchdown run. And as he got near the sideline, a University of Alabama player, Tommy Lewis, jumped off the sideline and tackled my uncle. So he's gone down in history for that play.
I recall seeing on the Ed Sullivan Show your uncle congratulating this man for apologizing, but I think your uncle was the great sportsman, and obviously you've continued in the great family tradition.
Well, thank you. It's fun to note that, 31 years later, there's Magel memories here, too, in Cotton Bowl history, so.
We're all proud of you. Our congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Thank you, too. Thank you, dear.
County Vocational Center in Athens, Tennessee, comes this dramatic float celebrating the historic ties between the states of Texas and Tennessee. It looks like the band is up before the float here. So we have the McKinn County High School Band of Athens, Tennessee.
Yeah, resplendent in brand new uniforms for the Cotton Bowl outing.
Last September, this proud bunch of musicians got the opportunity of playing Hail to the Chief for President Reagan when he made a major speech in their hometown. You know, I tried to get him to do that for me in my dressing room over at Warner Brothers. They wouldn't do it.
Congratulations to the McMinn County High School and for the Vocational Center's fine float. Coming up now is the scene. There we go. Let's see.
Oh,
there it is.
Dramatic float. Look at that. Beautiful.
The scene reenacts the heroic defense of the Alamo by Davy Crockett, Colonel Travis, and Jim Bowie.
This float was built and decorated by the vocational students. Now listen to this. They volunteered to work after school hours and on weekends. I'd say that is dedication.
Yeah, and those who worked the longest and the hardest were chosen to come to Dallas as the work crew for the float.
It's a remarkable job by a very talented group of young people. We've met the Cotton Bowl Queen and the Aggie Marching Band from Texas A&M, and now we salute a third entry from that fine university, the Parsons Mounted Cavalry.
This is a ceremonial mounted unit that participates in parades and rodeos all over Texas, including the San Antonio Battle of Flowers and the Fort Worth and Houston Livestock Shows. They recently rode in the 1985 inauguration parade for President Reagan and a native son of Texas, Vice President Bush.
Wow.
You know, I wish everyone I knew could be sitting here enjoying this parade, especially from my vantage point. All my friends, the cast and crew of my show Dallas. And Larry, I hear when you were here in 79, they referred to it as the Ice Bowl. It's a beautiful day here today. Happy New Year, everybody.
I want to send best wishes for a great 1986 to everybody connected with Scarecrow and Mrs. King, the cast and crew. Happy New Year.
Worked for pronouncing our names better than we do.
Absolutely.
In this part of the Cotton Bowl Parade, we'll be entertained by the Shriners of Dallas. But first, a little march in the music, Kim.
For a great bunch of marching musicians, how about this turnout from Danville High School in Illinois? Danville is 890 miles from Dallas as the crow flies.
That'd be a pretty fired crow. But when he gets here, and we certainly hope he does, he can listen to some rousing parade music from the Danville High School Vikings.
The average age of these musicians is 15 and a half, but it says to hear there's a youngster who's 13.
I hope he isn't the tuba player.
Yeah, I couldn't even take over. I gave it up. I really admire these kids, Peter. They work so hard practicing their music and raising money for this trip to the Cotton Bowl. That's what I call dedication. Look at those faces.
Genesis.
I think this is the first flautist we've seen today. Correct me if I'm wrong.
The first
flautist, flute player.
Oh, yes. Absolutely. Someone said the future of this country is in our youth, you know, and you look at these faces and you just, boy.
Looks like maybe everything could be okay.
Yeah, really. Did you ever play any instruments, Peter?
I did. I played trumpet until I was asked to stop by my teacher.
Oh, no. I always wanted to play the saxophone.
But that is true. Now we see here the first of our entries from the Hella Shrine Temple of Dallas. Sesquicentennial salute to the state of Texas. This float, by the way, won the sweepstakes prize.
You said it right again, Peter. I'm so embarrassed. It highlights the things that Texas is famous for, with the big oil rig spouting black gold for those famous Texas oil wells and the products of space research at the Johnson Space Center.
Plus a few Wranglers waiting on the old rail fence. It's my impression of Jimmy Stewart.
That was actually pretty bad. No, I'm pretty good.
And we're seeing now a rodeo cowboy. He's trying to stay aboard a high-kicking, well, wait, well, there he was, almost. He's trying to stay aboard a high-kicking longhorn. There he is.
There
longhorn
he was.
Steer, that is.
Oh, it's a state full of contrast, all right, all that action, and yet Texans are some of the nicest, most hospitable people you'll ever meet, Peter. Do you know that?
No, I'll vouch for that. Since we've been here, they've been wonderful for us. But I'll take the hospitality and leave the bull riding to the Texans.
I always wanted to do stuff like that.
Oh, you're nuts.
I am nuts. These crazy characters are the famous Hella Shrine Temple clowns with their own best pocket parade of five mini floats. First comes the clown corral with the rhinestone cowboy riding a bucking bronco. Behind, there's an unusual array of horses drilling to the tune of "Don't call him a cowboy until you see him ride."
Next, there's a noble animal that's listed as a genuine Texas longhorn, but that cowboy clown on his back knows he's really a bum steer.
Look at that. What? Oh, and where else but in Texas would you see a mobile doghouse towing an oil derrick? Of course, that isn't quite a typical Texas oil rig. It's spouting balloons instead of oil. A lot of people lost money on that one.
I guess so. Well, someone's balloon may be burst today. Here's a capsule preview of this afternoon's Cotton Bowl football game with two one-man teams on field in a miniature stadium, one representing the host team of Texas A&M and the other from Auburn.
Another activity of the Dallas Shriners is their mobile stage, sponsored by the director staff of the Hella Shrine Temple, the group that directs all of the various projects at the temple.
This mobile stage travels many miles, bringing entertainment to outlying localities. And the group playing on the stage right now is the famous Hella Director's Staff Band. They're quite a swinging Western band, and every one of these musicians is a member of the Hella Shrine Temple of Dallas.
Hella, I wonder where they got that name.
I think I'm the wrong person to ask. Maybe if we run out in the street, we can...
Well, you know the answer to everything, Peter. I just expected you to know
when
it.
It's written down for me.
Here's a special presentation by the Flying Pheasants of the Hella Shrine Temple of Dallas. This is a special group of Shriners who volunteer at their own expense to fly crippled and burned children to one of the Shrine Children's Hospital when the need arises.
On this float, there are three scale models of famous airplanes built in Texas. There's a legendary JN3 we're seeing, the famous Jenny of World War I. And shortly, we'll see the P-51 Mustang fighter plane of World War II, which I have been recently informed was flown by our own Hank Miles, who is the writer for today's parade.
Wow.
Dear gentlemen. So our hats off to him. And then we'll see up at the top there, you can see the modern supersonic fighter, the F-16, which is currently on active duty with our armed forces.
Did you know that more military pilots have been trained in Texas than in any other state? I guess the wild blue yonder must refer to the skies of the Lone Star State, or do you think I'm just partial?
Final entry.
anniversary of the Hella Shrine is the famous Black Horse Patrol. It's appeared in the Cotton Bowl Parade for 16 years.
This fine-looking unit, dressed in cowboy outfits, rides beautiful black registered quarter horses. They travel widely, contributing their talents to civic functions and charity events.
The Shriners have a lot of fun with their pageantry and clowning, but we should remember that their basic goal is a serious one.
Yes.
There are 18 orthopedic hospitals and 3 burn centers maintained by 180 shrine temples around the world. And this Black Horse Patrol is part of that effort. Their motto is, "We ride that crippled children may walk."
Wow.
I hope you're having as good a time as I am on, Alicia.
I am.
The only way I could have more fun than this would be to be out there on the street myself.
I'm sure you could be, Peter. I know you're a juggler, and I'm told that you can ride a unicycle. Now, tell me, can you juggle and ride a unicycle at the same time?
I certainly can.
Really?
But not on the day after New Year's Eve.
What a shame. I was hoping for a demonstration, Peter. Miss Ken, this is pleasure. We have floats, we have band, we have horses. Pleasure! Okay.
Martha, did you ever see a swarm of hornets marching?
Not yet, but I'm still young.
Well, you needn't get a day older, because here in person are the marching hornets of Preble Preble High School in Green Bay, Wisconsin.
Is that the same Green Bay with Green Bay Packers hang out?
It's the same, and they have the Packers colors on their band uniforms, too, and they've played a lot of Packer home games.
Well, it's obvious they deserve the honor. Let's listen.
Sesquicentennial theme is carried out in a spectacular style with this combination entry of a float and marching unit sponsored by AT&T.
It presents an international salute to Texas on its 150th anniversary. At its head is a marching triangular formation carrying the 6 flags of Texas, among others.
Yeah, the front part of the float unit is a replica of the Alamo with the Lone Star rising out of the historic fortress.
On the main body of the float, the peoples of the world, there they are, saluting Texas, dressed in colorful costumes of other lands.
And the trailing unit carries a big red, white, and blue map of Texas with gold numbers, commemorating this state's 150th anniversary.
And bringing up the rear, behind the state, well, you don't see it yet, but bringing up the rear is another marching unit repeating the 6 flag theme, a rousing tribute to a great state.
Texas is a state of great variety. It's got oil, minerals, cattle, cotton, and space research. Its basic strength has always been agriculture. And this float, sponsored by Owens County Foods and Morrison Milling Company, illustrates the point.
Behind the horse-drawn wagon, we see some Texas-bred livestock. A horn of plenty and... Look at the livestock. They're cute. A horn of plenty. And there we also have a modern farmer sitting at a computer.
Yeah, that's the way it's done these days. You know, I'm a farmer. I have a computer at my farm. This year I produced over 4,000 acres of popcorn in my company in southern Indiana. Ken Kirschenwald's old popper.
Oh, I love popcorn. Yeah. I'm going to have to try that. That's great. In Texas, a lot of young farmers get their training from the 4-H Club and the Future Farmers of America. You can see their emblems on the float. Here they are. And these two organizations are a strong influence here in Texas and throughout America's farmlands.
That's a nice tribute to farming. Now, if the roll of marching drums makes your pulse rate go up, this group should do the trick. They're the Cherokeettes of Shreveport, Louisiana, accompanied by the Captain Shreve High School Band.
Two
of their featured baton twirlers are title holders in local, state, and regional competitions. And you can certainly see why. Look at that.
Now, how about those red, white, and blue Western-style uniforms, huh? Mm-hmm. Trimmed with leather, sequins, and that, what do they call it, diamond dust?
Diamond dust.
Wow.
Oh, look how young.
Is this junior high school?
That's Cherokee-ed.
The
Cherokee make them young. Yeah. little Cherokees.
Right. Aren't they cute?
Yeah.
Well, they're taking some long steps there. Little short legs, long steps.
It's the drummerettes for the Cherokee-ed. The Captain Shreve High School Marching Band of Shreveport, Louisiana. I think you can hear them.
There they are. Huh?
And in a minute you will see them.
Yep. And they're going to be playing a medley of tunes from The Wizard of Oz.
It's like they're led up by an alligator here, doesn't it?
There is an alligator. You're absolutely right.
You're all waiting with bated breath to see this alligator. Here he is. Maybe that's a crocodile.
There, yeah. Here they come.
Yeah.
Okay, in the front. Hello, band. Yeah, all right.
Here they are.
Now, the front members on the horn line are the main characters from the show. The Tin Man, Scarecrow, Cowardly Lion, the Witch, and Dorothy.
The Scarecrow without Mrs. King? What is this? Well, incidentally, you know, that witch is really the little sister of two of the band members, so I don't think you're very scared of her.
I doubt that.
My favorite movie, Wizard of Oz. There's Dorothy. Cowardly Lion, Lioness. Yeah. Ding Dong, the Witch is Dead. Remember that song?
Yep, sure do. Every year, the Cotton Bowl Parade welcomes Dub Miller's Arabians, representing the Arabian Horse Club of America.
Mr. Miller is riding the big white stallion, Ibn Monty. His sire, Old Monty, was retired last year at the age of 30. Not bad, huh? For a horse that's in the league with Methuselah, I guess.
Yeah, the riders are dressed in the costumes of the native Bedouin tribesmen of North Africa. That's where the Arabian horse was bred and developed.
Gorgeous costumes. You know, Ken, organizing a great parade like this one takes a lot of talent and a lot of hard work, so I think we should take a moment and hand out a few bouquets there.
I really think it's the least we can do. Yeah. Chief Honcho, of course, is the man who puts it all together, parade director Jim Skinner.
He is a genius. He coordinates this parade with our planning staff of CBS and our fearless executive producer, Mike Gargiulo.
Somehow they bring it off every year. That's always a smashing success.
And it isn't over yet, so stay with us, folks. There's more parade coming up after this.
Threes.
To Kansas, here are the marching Trojans of Topeka High School. Their musical tribute to the 150th anniversary of Texas is highly appropriate. The King Cotton March.
Now, enhancing the effect of their music, they have two drum majors and a 24-member flag team, followed by what you're seeing now, the 132 band members.
Those capes really give them a swashbuckling appearance, don't they?
Swashbuckling, the perfect word. And they sound swashbuckling, too, if that's possible.
How does that sound?
Swash. The sound of swashes being buckled everywhere. Let's listen. This has got to be the best parade.
And the weather and the sky is so blue. It's just so special. It's going to be a good year for all of us.
God bless.
God bless.
So.
Sesquicentennial theme is repeated in this impressive float sponsored by the Dr. Pepper Company. This entry won the theme prize.
It traces the state's history from its beginnings, through its colorful past to its wonderful present. In the foreground, well, there we go, we see the covered wagon of the pioneers who faced the dangers of the new frontier to settle the western lands. These are the oil wells that became the nation's great new source of energy. And there, the San Jacinto Monument symbolizing the final freedom of Texas from foreign rule and the tall buildings of the bustling cities of modern Texas.
The space shuttle dramatizes the vital contributions of Texas to the space age.
And a giant Lone Star flag flies over the whole scene. And I guess it's true what has been said before. The eyes of Texas are upon you.
Ah, that makes chills go up and down my spine. Another bunch of swashbucklers wearing capes, the Golden Bear Marching Band of Edison High School in San Antonio, Texas. Those big letters are carried by the band dads who helped raise the funds for their trip to Dallas.
And the year before that, they won the Paseo del Rey Feo competition in the annual Fiesta San Antonio. Did I say that right, Ana Alicia? Paseo del Rey Feo.
Well, you said it pretty close. Paseo del Rey Feo.
Not bad for a gringo, huh?
Not bad for a gringo. And we'll have more to say about it in just a moment. But first, let's hear them serenade their hometown with San Antonio Road. Here comes a float representing the annual civic celebration known as Fiesta San Antonio.
Every spring, Fiesta San Antonio salutes the city's multiple cultures and commemorates the heroes of Texas history.
At each end of the float, there are large figures illustrating the blending of the cultures of Texas as they celebrate the sesquicentennial. A giant piñata stands at the center, surrounded by a kaleidoscope of colored flowers celebrating Fiesta San Antonio.
There are four Fiesta queens on board. Marlene Gonzalez as Miss Charo, Cynthia Fears as Miss Fiesta San Antonio, Marinella Martinez as Miss San Antonio Charo, and Christia Deli as Queen of Soul.
Here's to Fiesta San Antonio, or as we say,
Olé!
Folks, here's another return engagement. Donna counts. Well, of course she does. Donna counts.
Everyone counts.
We all do. Donna counts of Seganville, Texas, riding a magnificent Arabian stallion, the multiple champion, Farnenna.
Peter, I'm not sure how this happened, but our parade is almost over.
Almost.
I'm so depressed.
Well, but not quite. You see, we've still got quite a few surprises in store.
Well, that's some consolation. Well, give me a for instance, Peter.
Well, for instance, we've got two more beautiful floats, two more bands.
And a drill team of gorgeous girls.
Sounds good to me.
I knew it would.
This is the Panther Regiment Marching Band from Midlothian. Now, that's not the county in Scotland nor the suburb of Chicago. This is Midlothian, southeast of Dallas, Texas.
What town? What geography, Kevin? Very scholarly of you.
Good man. So far this year, 70% of these young musicians are on their school's honor roll, and 12 of them have a straight A average.
Woo! That's amazing. All those brains and what musical talent, too. Let's listen to them.
Now, this is the first day of the new year, which means it's the first day of the Texas Sesquicentennial 2. So here's a timely tip of the 10-gallon hat to the Lone Star State, sponsored by the State Fair of Texas.
The procession is led by the traditional covered wagon, drawn by a team of oxen, followed by a whole cavalcade of Texas history.
And there's a 10-foot replica of the legendary cowboy, Big Tex, an oversized armadillo, a big map of Texas, and an oil derrick of the famous Spindletop Field.
And finally, half a dozen daughters of the Lone Star State standing proudly under the Six Flags of Texas. Pretty costumes.
That's a pretty float to kick off the Sesquicentennial.
Sesquicentennial.
Did you know the tornadoes come in different colors?
No.
Well, I tell you, they do. And these young musicians call themselves the Blue Tornadoes. They're from Richland High School in Richland, Virginia.
And they are decked out today in brand new uniforms. They're beautiful to see and they're beautiful to hear.
Yeah, there they are. While they're doing their number, let's turn things back to Annalise and Peter so we can work our way over to the anchor position for the finale.
Okay. Roses of Texas, both yellow and otherwise, and roses are the subject of the Sesquicentennial bouquet from the rose capital of the world.
Every year, harvest time, the Texas Rose Festival is held in Pilardon in the multi-million dollar rose industry. Folks everywhere, thanks for watching us today. We had a wonderful time. Hi, Mom. Hi, Nana. In Cape Cod.
Hi, Mom and Dad in Farmington, Michigan. Oh, I love my family. Happy New Year, everybody. I love you so much, and my friends, and my friend Morgan, and everybody. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
It's been a wonderful parade.
We're glad you could join our party. So to all of you, from all of us,
Martha Smith,
Annalisa,
Kershaw,
and Peter Scolari,
Happy New Year!
The 1986 CBS Cotton Bowl Parade was sponsored by Listerine to help fight plaque for better oral hygiene, and by Publishers Clearinghouse. This house could mean $10 million.